Hey, good afternoon, everyone. My name is Elizabeth Adams, and I'm a meteorologist with the National Weather Service. This is your weekly weather briefing. Low clouds continue to blanket the coastal basin as Grapril wears on. Very little clearing is expected for the coast and valleys today, and areas of patchy drizzle will be possible for the rest of the afternoon. Elsewhere, high clouds are streaming across the Pacific Northwest, and some clearing is noted across the ocean. Widespread snow cover can still be seen across the Sierra Nevada and other mountain ranges across the western United States, though that snowpack will continue to shrink this week as a trough that is currently bringing us cool temperatures, gusty winds, and clouds will progress eastward and a ridge of high pressure builds late this week into the weekend. Winds will increase this afternoon across the mountains and deserts, and gusty westerly winds will persist into early Wednesday morning. The strongest winds will occur across the mountains, the San Gorgonio Pass near Banning, and the high and low deserts, where a wind advisory is in effect from this afternoon through Tuesday night. Peak wind gusts of 45 to 55 miles per hour are expected, though higher wind gusts in excess of 60 miles per hour will be possible in wind-prone passes and canyons. Blowing dust may lead to reduced visibility in the deserts, so use caution if you're traveling, especially across the lower deserts, the next few days. Travel may become hazardous, especially in crosswinds for high-profile vehicles. Minor tree damage is possible, and loose objects could become airborne and blow away. Winds will also be quite gusty across the outer coastal waters this week, with northwest winds of 25 to 30 knots expected through late Wednesday night. High combined seas is 6 to 10 feet, and gusty winds will lead to conditions that are hazardous to small craft, so inexperienced mariners should avoid navigating in those conditions. Winds will subside through Thursday morning. As we remain under the influence of the upper-level trough, temperatures will remain quite cool the next several days. In fact, highs will generally top up 5 to 10 degrees below normal region-wide, with highs as much as 15 degrees below average in the mountains. Expect highs in the 60s for Tuesday and Wednesday for the coast, valleys, and high desert, the 50s for the mountains, and the 80s for the lower desert. Temperatures will finally begin to rebound on Thursday as skies clear out and winds briefly turn offshore. Highs will reach near to slightly above normal for most areas, though the high desert may remain a degree or two below average. Sunshine will be abundant, which will be a welcome change from our dreary past few days. On Friday, highs will continue to climb as high pressure builds across the eastern Pacific into the western United States. Highs will reach the upper 70s for the coast as well as the high desert, the 80s for the valleys, the 60s and 70s for the mountains, and the 90s for the lower desert. High temperature departure from normal will be 8 to 12 degrees above normal for most areas, so it will be a hot day. Make sure if you're out in the sun to stay hydrated, wear sunscreen, and take frequent breaks in the shade or indoors with air conditioning. Stay safe and enjoy the sunshine and warmth. Finally, let's look ahead as we progress towards the last week of April. The Climate Prediction Center is calling for a chance for above normal temperatures and near normal precipitation chances for April 23rd to the 27th. This pattern favors a ridge center near the Four Corners region. It seems like our warming and drying pattern will continue through the next 10 or so days. Thanks so much for watching. Please make sure to follow us on social media for forecast updates and visit weather.gov/sgx for the most up-to-date thinking on the forecast. Have a great week.